Hey, thanks, guys. A big hockey night in Columbus tonight, a big soccer night in Columbus on Friday night. That's why these two gentlemen are with me, Stu Holden and Alexi Lalas, a couple of Fox Sports analysts. FS1 carries the U.S. men's national team game against Mexico Friday night. I'll start with you, Alexi. How excited are you to be back in Columbus for this big World Cup qualifier?
Love it. Love it. I love Columbus just in general, but to come back for a U.S.-Mexico game, and the U.S.-Mexico game has just taken on a life of itself. Mm-hmm. Here in Columbus, the people love it. It's a mecca. There is a migration and a bucket list type of feel for people that just want to come here and want to experience what it is on the field in terms of the game and off the field in terms of the environment.
I was at the last one, and I agree with you completely. Stu, we know what happens when the USA and Mexico get together at Mofre Stadium. It's always 2-0, right?
Yeah,
and it always goes the home team way. What's going on with that?
I can't explain it, honestly. I don't know how it's become this docecero. Even in the last edition, Clint Dempsey, who scores a lot of goals from penalty kicks, has a penalty, and he puts it wide. And everyone then starts to conspiracy theory saying, oh, well, he just wanted it to be docecero again so we could continue this tradition. Honestly, I don't know how it happens. It's an amazing home field advantage for the United States. It's a mental edge. It's one that the Mexican team look at when they come to Columbus and they're like, we cannot win in this place. Almost how the U.S. were going to Azteca. So it's really great. And as Alexi said, it's become almost this tradition that was just born back in 2001. And Columbus has kept it and they keep owning it.
And I'm sure they'd like to own it again tonight. Guys, we just had a little ceremony, the traditional jersey swap, only tonight. It was a little different. Hockey players and soccer players. Alexi, where does that tradition come from, the old jersey swap, either before or after a game?
Well, after the game, usually what happens is once the fighting is done, your friends, you exchange your jersey because this is what has represented you in soccer over the last 90 minutes. And it's starting to be part of other sports. We've seen football players do it, hockey players do it. And as you know, when it comes to soccer and hockey, there's a lot of similarities in the actual sport and the movements, but also in the international involvement of the NHL or Major League Soccer. And so I think it lends it really well to the sport to have this moment where while you might be fighting and literally fighting at times against your opponent when it comes to hockey, at the end of the game, you trade and you recognize and you respect the person that you're playing against, and you have a little memento to take home.
Yeah, I like it. So, Stu, I like the sweater. You want to swap?
Yeah. I was already telling you I liked your jacket.
Yeah, let's.
Hey, you're not going to fit.
You don't even fit. This is a kid's extra small.
Yeah, that won't work. All right, FS1, Friday night, 7 o'clock. Make sure you watch it from Mofre Stadium if you're not already going to be there. But not bad to sit back and watch it on TV. Guys, thank you very much and enjoy Nationwide Arena.
Thank you.